The funeral had the feel of a celebration of life even before it began. The mood quieted a few minutes later as Vice President Joe Biden walked in to pay his respects to applause and then to a standing ovation. The Vice President then sat unassumingly just a few rows back near a legion of political and civic leaders. Amid devout prayers and gorgeous song, the funeral began, Congresswoman Marcia Fudge speaking for the elected officials, as Lou Stokes had requested her to do, recalling many of his accomplishments, then adding,
"Yes, I'm saying that if Lou Stokes is not in heaven, most of us can forget about him."
Representative Fudge talked about Lou Stokes' service to others, how he taught and mentored so many over so many years, including herself.
"Make no mistake, my friends, we mourn this day the loss of no ordinary man."
Three of Lou Stokes' grandchildren offered wonderful glimpses into a man they revered, some of those glimpses laced with poignant humor, starting with Nicolette Thompson.
"Granddaddy and I love our Cleveland sports teams. Rooting for the Browns, the Indians, and of course the Cavaliers is how I first learned about loyalty.
Everyone was equal in his eyes, and his love for his friends, his family, his constituents, and anyone else he encountered truly knew no bounds.
Granddad practically wrote the book on how to be a father and a grandfather. That's why I gave him the name Superman, which became an endearing term for our family. After all, Superman was born in Cleveland."
The Reverend Dr. Otis Moss Jr. delivered a stirring eulogy, recalling how the boy born into poverty who grew up in the projects rose above his circumstances through hard work.
"Stokes' life called out like the prophet Amos, let justice roll down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream."
Reverend Moss said Lou Stokes' greatness came in part from his service to others, and he always knew the order of the two.
"And remember, service always precedes greatness."
A short time later came the benediction.
"We commit your honorable servant."
And then Lou Stokes was taken to his final resting place for a private burial. The boy from the projects of Cleveland who sought the American dream, served in the Army, went to college and law school, became an iconic political figure, all while remaining a humble family man. The portrait that emerges is of a life well lived, a life that lived up to that American dream.